Hello, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I wanted to talk to you about how to use your TI-36X Pro to do probability distributions. And the first example, we're talking about a single outcome. What is the probability of getting exactly one heads when you flip a coin three times? And when I start my calculator, the TI-36X Pro, I always want to clear the memory out. So in order to do that, I'm going to turn it on. I'm going to press on and clear twice. And what that does is it clears the memory of anything. So on and clear does that. And now I'm going to follow the directions that I have here. Second function data, because second function puts you above the actual key of data. So second function data, and then over to distribution. So I'm going to use the arrow key here to go over. And then I want to go down to number 4 on the list, which is binomial PDF. So I'm going to go down to number 4, and then I'm going to hit enter. Just down here and hit enter. So now it puts me into the binomial PDF choices. I have single, list, or all. I just want to know one thing, exactly one heads. That's a single value. So I'm going to do single, hit enter. And then I want, I said there was going to be three trials, so our trial should be 3. The probability of success of getting a heads is half or 0.5. And the number I'm looking for is x equals 1. So what's the chance of getting one heads in all that information? And so I'm going to hit enter twice, and then it's going to tell me the value is 0.375. that means the probability of getting one heads when you flip a coin three times is 0.375. this is what we'd expect, because 2 to the 3rd power would give us our sample space, because there's 2 outcomes, heads or tails, and we have 3 trials. So 2 to the 3rd power would be 8 outcomes, and then 3 of the 8 have exactly one head, which is, I've put boxes around the 3. This is the entire sample space of what could happen if you flip 3 coins. 3 have just one heads, but you can see also, if I were looking how many times would I get exactly one tails, there's 3 of those as well, which would be the same, right? So asking exactly one heads or exactly one tails is going to give me the same answer. Okay, the second kind I'm going to look at is at most. When you're looking at most, this one says, what's the probability of getting at most 2 heads when you flip a coin 5 times? When you're asking that at most, what you're saying is it would be okay if I got 0, or if I got 1, or if I got 2. But that's the most I could get was 2. So I'm actually looking for all these probabilities added together. Okay, and so to do this, the easiest way is all, and I'll show you why you might want to use list, but we're going to go back and clear our data again. So on clear twice. I don't want anything in there to mess me up. Now I'm going to go second function data, over to distribution again, down to number 5 actually is CDF. So we should put 5 there. And so I'm going to go down to number 5, CDF, C meaning cumulative. I'm going to add up those things. So that's what the CDF is. So I'm going to hit enter. And then I'm going to go with all first. And that's going to give me all the probabilities in the cumulative list of those. So I'm going to hit enter, and then I have 5 trials again. And I have a probability of 0.5. I can put 0.52. And then I'm going to hit enter. And this is telling me it's going to put my information in L1, which is fine. And so I hit enter again to calculate, and enter again to actually make that happen. So what I have here is this list, and it shows me in my first position I have 0.03125. And my second position I have 0.1875. Now that just means that if I added together the first and the second, that would get to that. And in the third position I have 0.5, and that means I wanted those first 3, right? That means that my probability of having a 0, 1, or 2, because it added it up for me, adds up to 0.5. Now, why that's confusing is because you have to realize that the first value, even though it says L1, is actually 0. And so I'll show you what you can do if you want to be a little more clear about that. Let's clear all this. On, clear, clear. Okay. Second function data, and then go over to distribution, and again down to number 5. Hit enter, and then I'm going to go to list. Oh, I need to do data first. 0, 1, and 2. So I'm going to enter the 3 data points that I'm interested in. The 0, 1, and 2 is going to get entered. Then second function data, distribution, down to 5, hit enter. Now I just want the list. I don't want all, just the list. And I'm going to do that, hit enter. And then there was 5 trials, probability of 0.5, hit enter again to get me down there. This is saying my list was in L1, my answers are going to be in L2, which is good. And then I hit calculate. And you can see a little more clearly when you do it this way that this is the 0 heads, 1 heads, 2 heads. And it adds it up as it goes. So that if having at most 2, there's a half a chance or 0.5 chance I get at most 2. Okay, and the last one is at least. And this is a little harder to do on the calculator, but not that big of a deal. But when you're saying what is the probability of getting at least 2, and this is 5 flips again, at least 2 means you could get 2, 3, 4, or 5, at least 2 or more, right? So when you're saying at least 2, you're actually saying greater than or equal to 2. And to do that, what we want to do is look at what's happening below that, because it's going to sum it up, and so you can't jump in the middle and sum up to the end, but you can sum the middle, I mean the end, and then subtract. So we're going to do that. We're going to take 1 minus the probability of getting something less than 2, and that's basically 0 and 1. So we're going to enter into data the values that are interesting of interest to us, and that's the ones below 2. So on clear, and I'm going to hit data and enter 0 and 1, and that's going to that's it. And then second function data distribution down to number 5, because I'm going to sum up 0 and 1 here. Hit enter. I want a list because I said what values I had. There was 5 trials, 0.5, and then I'm going to put that into L2, which is fine, and hit calculate. And so that gives me the 0.185. That's the probability that it would be less than 2. And now I can just say, okay, if I subtract that from 1, I have all the possibilities that it's going to be 2 or more, which is what I was looking for. All right, have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.